Patient, known diabetic, came with the chief complaints of ulcer in the left sole of foot for the past 1 month. History of presenting illness. Patient was apparently asymptomatic 1 month back, after which he developed a bleb in the sole of the left foot and gradually progressed, for which he underwent debridement 1 month back and came with the ulcer of the present size. No history of fever, no history of any active pus discharge, no history of pain. Past medical history, patient is a known diagnosed to be diabetic 1 year ago and was on EvoChase and was irregular treatment. Past surgical history, patient underwent re-amputation of right great toe 1 year ago in GH. Personal history, patient takes mixed diet, normal bowel and bladder habits, sleep pattern is normal, not a smoker, not an alcoholic. Family history and ill significant. Moving on to general examination.
General examination. Pallor present. No ictus, no sinus, no clubbing, no generalized lymphadenopathy, no pedal edema. Local examination.
Come to the mic. Cannot hear.
Local examination. Single ulcer of size 12x8 cm present over the sole of left foot with no active pus discharge. Granulation tissue is seen. As the floor with well-defined margins and sloping edges. On palpation, inspector findings are confirmed. The base of the ulcer is found to be the tendons as well as the bone. The surrounding skin is normal and no regional lymphadenopathy. Peripheral pulses are well felt. So coming to the summary, 65-year-old gentleman diagnosed diabetic for the past 1 year on irregular medication, came with ulcer of size 12x8 cm of the sole of left foot with no complications, Wagner grade 1.
Sir, did you mention the peripheral pulses?
Yes ma'am, peripheral pulses are well felt.
But you didn't mention, you have to mention the neurologically whether patient is normal, pulse is felt, any dilated veins are there, everything you have to...
Nothing is significant.
Inspection also you have to tell.
Yes, ma'am. All peripheral pulses are well felt. Sensations are also intact. No complications of diabetes are there for this patient.
How did you test for the sensation?
With the esthesiometer. Esthesiometer.
What?
Yammer illa. The monofilament.
With the monofilaments. What are the sensation you tested and how did you do?
Monofilament for the cutaneous sensation and for warmth and cold sensations, we checked with the ice cube.
Where did you palpate the dorsalis pedis?
Just lateral to the extensor hallucis tendon over there.
It's not clear. Be very clear. Where did you palpate the dorsalis pedis?
Lateral to the extensor hallucis tendon over the navicular.
Lateral to the extensor hallucis?
Over the navicular.
Over the?
Navicular.
What, ma'am? Uniform and navicular. Over the navicular. Where do you palpate the tibialis posterior? All this you have to read. We cannot take class here. You have not told how you tested the tensations. What are the sensations you have not told? Number two, you don't know the landmark for the vessels. Posterior, tibialis posterior. Posterior tibial artery. All the pulses are felt, but where did you feel it? Chuma routine, because the case is not here, you just tell like that.
Between the lateral malleolus and the Achilles tendon.
Between the lateral malleolus
and the Achilles tendon.
Achilles tendon. Achilles tendon is a long one. Where, which part of the Achilles tendon? The surrounding skin is normal.
Yes, ma'am.
How can it be normal with such an ulcer there? Okay, what are the things you looked for the skin around the ulcer?
Any discoloration?
Discoloration. What is the discoloration you get? In red, blue, black?
In reddish discoloration.
Reddish.
In case of active inflammation, if there is reddish discoloration.
So you look for any color change, then what else will you look? In the surrounding skin. Do you look for edema?
There is no edema, ma'am.
No, you said it's normal. I am asking you now, what did you look for? You just said normal.
Whether there is any pedal edema, whether the hair and...
More than pedal edema, the immediate surrounding thing. So when you examine an ulcer, you have to examine the ulcer, the surrounding skin and the surrounding structures. Did you examine the joint close to the ulcer? What was the joint close to the ulcer?
The ankle joint.
Which one? Ankle joint. Did you examine for the ankle joint? No. How was the joint? Didn't examine.
Patient is walking.
Patient is walking, so you leave it off. You have to see. How will you examine the ankle joint? What are the... How do you... You have not done it, but how do you do it? Tell me.
Dorsi and plantar flexion, internal and external rotation.
So how do you do? Active or passive? Both you have to do, no? You have to answer me like that. I ask the patient, active movement, dorsiflexion, inversion, eversion, everything. And if we cannot do, I can do it. Was there any swelling in the ankle joint?
No, ma'am.
Define ulcer.
A break in continuity in the epithelial with the molecular death.
My God.
With molecular cell death.
You cannot define an ulcer. Which year you are in?
Final year.
Final year? No, ma. You have to read. You have to read. This is very bad. You said he is on irregular treatment. What is the treatment? Did you mention what was the treatment? Is it insulin or oral hypoglycemic?
Oral nothing? Hypoglycemic.
You didn't mention that.
OHAs. Oral hypoglycemics he was taking for the past 1 year.
Okay. Completely it has... You have to reorganize your examination and study. You have to define ulcer. Define margin. Edge. What do you mean by a punched out edge? What do you mean by a punched out edge? Come closer to the thing and tell me.
Will be in TBA.
You should be very thorough with ulcer. You should be very thorough. There is no surgery exam without a case of ulcer. Correct, sir? There is no exam. Thyroid illama kuda irukalam, breast illama irukka, but not without ulcer. So you will, from the definition, this is taught from the first semester itself, no? Third, when you come to the clinics, ulcer tha, we are teaching you. Until now, you don't know that? What is a punched out edge? What is edge? First of all, define an edge.
Edges, the line, junction between the margin and the floor of the ulcer.
Okay, one answer you gave me. Sir?
What is base, what is floor?
Base is an palpatory finding, floor is an inspectory finding. Base is where the ulcer rests. Base is where the ulcer rests, it's a palpatory finding, floor is an inspectory finding. Syphilis and tuberculosis.
Huh?
Syphilis, tuberculosis.
Syphilis, tuberculosis.
No.
Tuberculosis,
syphilis.
You get.
Tuberculosis, you get punched out. Yeah. What type of edge you will get in tuberculosis?
Rolled out, no?
No. Undermined.
In diabetic foot, what type of.
Sloping, healing. Sloping edges.
Diabetic
diabetic
food. Healing also you get slow pain.
Yes.
Diabetic food?
If it's healing, it will be sloping. This was a healing ulcer. It had sloping edges.
What do you call those ulcers as in diabetic?
This
where
was
do you get those ulcers?
On pressure areas, so trophic ulcer.
What is all these ulcers due to? Why do they get the ulcer? Diabetic people.
In diabetes, there will be loss of sensation.
Due
so
to diabetic peripheral neuropathy. Okay.
Neuropathy, and they will initially it will start as a bleb, and then it will gradually progress. One is due to uncontrolled diabetes. The healing will be less, and even the sensation. So it will progress and.
Not only neuropathy, vasculopathy.
Vasculopathy.
This case you are not mentioned about base. What's a base? This case finding,
sir. You,
base of the ulcer.
The tendons.
No, pardon.
Tendons.
Tendon.
And the muscles.
In malignant ulcer, what's a finding? Base of the ulcer. So basic thing you have to know. So very important. Base is indurated. You have to mention all the things. Okay. You never mentioned about base, margins, everything. So left over all the things. In the diabetic ulcer, there are three causes for neuropathy, microangiopathy, and gliadin tissue. That is very important. So microangiopathy, how long takes time in diabetic patient develop microangiopathy? How many years? So 1 year can you develop the patient develop angiopathy?
Unlikely.
Pardon? How many years it takes?
This ulcer is for 1 month.
Illalla. Minimum of 10 years.
10 years. So that's very important. Okay, what's your diagnosis? What's your diagnosis?
Healing diabetic foot ulcer over the left sole.
Pardon?
Healing diabetic foot ulcer over the left sole of the foot. Wagner grade 1.
Due to? What's the etiology? Okay, what's the treatment? What's the investigation? Only certain investigation. Tell us specific investigation for this patient.
For this patient, we'd like to do an X-ray to check for any bony involvement. We'd like to take a pus culture in order to give appropriate antibiotics. Then daily dressing followed by an SSG.
What's the finding in the X-ray, local X-ray in bony changes?
No bony changes, sir.
What bony changes?
No evidence of osteomyelitis or osteolysis.
Okay, what's the treatment this patient?
For this patient, after giving an appropriate antibiotic cover, we'd like, and after getting glycemic control, achieving glycemic control, we'd like to go ahead with a split skin graft.
Any other thing, surgery? Do you want us to do the surgery? This patient? Only medical treatment?
No, split skin graft. After achieving glycemic control and antibiotic control, we'd like to go ahead with a split skin graft.
Split skin graft. What are the layers involved? SSG. What are the layers? Skin layers.
Superficial. Till superficial dermis.
Come to the mic. Come to the mic.
Till superficial dermis.
Superficial.
Including dermis.
Superficial derm. Till papillary.
So part of the dermis layer.
Yes.
So any other surgery? Only the SSG. Any other surgery?
For this patient, I'd like to go ahead with an SSG since it is only covering the arch of the foot and it's not affecting the pressure areas. An SSG will most likely take up for this patient.
Okay, any other questions?
Sir? A flap will be preferred over the pressure areas rather than an SSG.
Okay, doctor. Types of flap. So SSG, flap cover, finally the amputations. That's a very important thing. Okay, thank you for...
What is the antibiotic you will give? What antibiotic?
We'll wait for the pus culture. Empirically, we can give...
Did you tell that? Even before you start any antibiotic, what is your first thing you should do? Even in the OPD, what you have to send? Pus culture and sensitive. Did you tell that? No.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. The two cases presented today, the multinodular goiter and the diabetic foot, are the cases kept for the postgraduate examination. All the postgraduates to be thorough with the questions asked by the examiners. Prepare well for the exams. It is not enough. No, you need to tell the basics first. Define an ulcer, you should not get easily you should answer, because it's all taught in the early clinical side. Preclinical side itself, we teach you what is an ulcer, definition of ulcer, the edge, base, everything we teach. That is what asked in the examination again and again. So you should be thorough with the presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, postgraduates. Thank you, panelists. I now request Professor R. Kannan, Director, Institute of General Surgery, Madras Medical College, to honor our panelists with the certificates.